Hello everyone, this is Asha, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, Tertiary College, Mysore. Today I am going to give a lecture on nucleic acid. This topic is from Unit 1st of 4th semester. The contents which I am going to deal today is nucleic acid, the types of nucleic acid, DNA and RNA, components of the DNA, nucleosides and nucleotides, structure of DNA, types of DNA, and functions of DNA. Moving on to the history of the nucleic acid, Frederick Mischer, a Swiss physician, discovered it in the year 1869. He extracted from the pus cells of the surgical bandages and he named it as nucleon because it was present inside the nucleus. His own scholar named Richard Altman, after 20 years, he renamed it as nucleic acid because when he studied the substance, he found that it has a high molecular weight and also they are acidic in nature. Because of the acidic nature, the name nucleon was converted into nucleic acid. Levine, in the year 1935, pointed out that there are two types of nucleic acid, DNA and RNA. DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, RNA as ribonucleic acid. Wherever the DNA is absent, in those organisms, RNA will act as a genetic material. Otherwise, the main role of RNA is protein synthesis. So, DNA's role is only the genetic material, whereas RNA acts both as a genetic material and protein synthesis. Moving on to deoxyribonucleic acid, they are present in the viruses as a genetic material. The virus which contain DNA is called as DNA virus. They are present in prokaryotic cells in the region called as nucleoid. Some of the extra chromosomal DNA which is present in a prokaryotic cell is named as plasmid. They play a very important role in genetic engineering. Eukaryotic cells contain DNA inside the nucleus. And some of the organelles, membrane-bound organelles called as chloroplast and mitochondria also contain DNA, and that DNA is called as organelle DNA. So here you can see the picture of a bacteriophage, a phage or a virus which attacks bacteria. So this is having a genetic material as DNA. This virus is called as DNA virus. This is the structure of a bacterial cell, a E. coli, Escherichia coli. So, it contains the genetic material as a DNA in the region called as nucleoid. And there is a presence of extra chromosomal DNA also, and that is called as plasmid. Plasmid play a very important role in genetic engineering. This is an eukaryotic cell, an animal cell, in which you can see the DNA is present inside the nucleus. And they coil around the histone proteins. These are organelle DNA, the mitochondria and chloroplast. Mitochondria is present in both plants and animal cell, whereas chloroplast is present only in the plant cell. Both of them, they have their own DNA, and the DNA present inside the mitochondria is called as a mitochondrial DNA, and the DNA present in a chloroplast is called as chloroplast DNA. Because of the presence of the own DNA, they are also called as autonomous cell organelles. DNA as a genetic material. Genetic material is a material which is composed of genes. And we all know that genes are the unit of heredity, the character which is transformed from parent to the offsprings. It helps to control the expressions of the character and traits in an organism. If a material is a genetic material, then it should have the following characters. First, replicate. It should be able to replicate. So if it is able to present its own replica, then only it can transfer that to the daughter cells. Next, mutation. Usually, the genetic materials are very much stable. If suppose if it undergoes a mutation, then it should be inheritable. Third, it should have the capacity to translate the genetic information and it has to transcribe into the protein synthesis. Chemical composition of nucleic acid. There are two types of nucleic acid, DNA and RNA. So these nucleic acids are polymers of nucleotides. Many nucleotides combine together to form this nucleic acids. The nucleotides have three components: the pentose sugar, nitrogenous base, and phosphate group. Pentose sugar, penta means 5 carbon compound sugar. The pentose sugar present in RNA is called as ribose sugar with the formula C5H10O5, and the pentose sugar present in DNA is deoxyribose sugar with the formula C5H10O4. So you can see that one oxygen is missing. So one oxygen is less. So from the ribose sugar, if one oxygen is removed from the second position, then the name comes 2-deoxyribose sugar. So that's the only difference between ribose and deoxyribose. So from the second carbon of the ribose sugar, the oxygen has been removed and it will form the deoxyribose sugar. The RNA has two functional groups, that is OH group, as you have seen in the structure, in the carbon number 2 and 3. Whereas in DNA, there is only one functional group which is present in carbon number 3. More the functional groups, more reactive they are. So RNA is more reactive when compared to DNA. DNA is more stable in nature. The second component of nucleotide is nitrogenous base. There are two types of nitrogen bases. One is purine, the other one is pyrimidine. Purines are dicyclic in nature, that is, they are double ring structures. There are two types of purine, adenine and guanine. Adenine is represented by a capital letter A and guanine by capital letter G. Both adenine and guanine is common purines for DNA as well as RNA. The four nitrogen atoms present in the double ring structures, you can see 1, 3, 7th and 9th position. Pyrimidines, they are monocyclic in nature, means they are single ring structures. They are of three types: thymine, cytosine and uracil. Thymine is denoted by capital letter T, cytosine by C and uracil by U. Cytosine is common in both DNA as well as RNA. But the other pyrimidine which is present in DNA is thymine and in RNA it is uracil. So in general I can say that thymine and cytosine are the pyrimidine bases in DNA, whereas cytosine and uracil are the pyrimidine bases in RNA. The two nitrogen atoms present in this cycle is in first and third position. Third component is phosphoric acid, that is H3PO4, also called as orthophosphoric acid. This is a very dilute acid with 85% of water. It is attached to the fifth carbon of pentose sugar when it forms the nucleotide. Nucleosides. Nitrogenous base plus pentose sugar forms a nucleoside. Always, there are two types of nitrogenous bases as we have studied before, that is purine and pyrimidine. Both the purine and pyrimidine, they form a bond with the first carbon of pentose sugar, and the bond which is formed is called as glycosidic bond. In purine, the first carbon of pentose sugar joins with the ninth position of purine. In pyrimidine, first carbon of pentose sugar form a glycosidic bond with the first position of pyrimidine. Here you can see the structure of the nucleoside, where the purine, the ninth position, is joined with the first carbon atom of pentose sugar, and in pyrimidine, the first position of pyrimidine and the first position of the pentose sugar forms the glycosidic bond. Nucleosides of DNA. The pentose sugar which is present in DNA is deoxyribose sugar. When it joins with the nitrogenous bases, it will form the nucleosides. So deoxyribose sugar plus adenine will give rise to deoxyadenosine. Deoxyribose sugar plus guanine will form deoxyguanosine. Deoxyribose sugar plus cytosine will give rise to deoxycytidine. Deoxyribose sugar plus thymine will form deoxythymidine. Nucleotides. Nucleotides are nothing but they are nucleoside plus phosphate group. Means all the three components, that is nitrogenous base, pentose sugar and phosphate group together, they form the nucleotides. Nitrogenous base and pentose sugar, they join by forming a glycosidic bond. Whereas the pentose sugar and phosphate group, they form a phosphodiester bond. phosphodiester bond is formed between the carbon number 5 of pentose sugar with the phosphoric acid or phosphoric group by the elimination of water molecule. So this is a structure where you can see the nucleoside and nucleotide. Nucleotides of DNA. So nucleoside plus phosphate group is nucleotide, and we all know that nucleoside is nothing but it is pentose sugar plus nitrogenous base. Now phosphate is group is coming and adding to it, and that's what give rise to the nucleotide. Deoxyadenosine plus phosphate will give rise to deoxyadenosine monophosphate. You can see it's a single phosphate, that's why deoxyadenosine monophosphate, which is also called as DAMP or deoxyadenylic acid. When deoxyguanosine combines with phosphate, it will give rise to deoxyguanosine monophosphate or deoxyguanylic acid. Deoxycytidine with phosphate give rise to deoxycytidine monophosphate or deoxycytidylic acid. Deoxythymidine with phosphate will give rise to deoxythymidine monophosphate or deoxythymidylic acid. Structure for DNA. We have studied in the history that DNA was discovered by Frederick Mischer, and the name was given by him was nuclein, which was converted into nucleic acid by his own scholar Richard Altman. And this name acid comes due to the phosphoric acid which is present in it. The term DNA was given by Zacharias, and we all know now that it is a polymer of nucleotide, consists of pentose sugar, nitrogenous base and phosphate group. Pentose sugar is deoxyribose sugar. The nitrogenous bases purines are adenine and guanine, and pyrimidine are cytosine and thymine. The phosphate group is orthophosphoric acid. Franklin and Wilkins in the year 1950, using a X-ray crystallographic technique, indicated the possible helical structure. This was the structure of Franklin's work which helped Watson and Crick to propose the double helix structure which we study today. Chargaffs in 1948 gave a Chargaffs rule, which is also called as base equivalence rule. According to this rule, always purine will pair with pyrimidine. Adenine forms a double bond with thymine and guanine forms a triple bond with cytosine. Because of this pairing of purine with pyrimidine, the diameter of our DNA always remain constant. So according to the rule, the number of purine is always equal to the number of pyrimidine. So double helix structure of DNA. So 1953 was the year when James D. Watson and Crick proposed the double helix structure of our DNA. For this Nobel work, they got a Nobel Prize in the year 1962. They shared the Nobel Prize with Morris Wilkins. The hard work of Franklin was a boon for Watson, Crick and Wilkins. It was a picture which she took through the X-ray diffraction images of her DNA, which helped Watson and Crick to propose the double helix structure of DNA molecule. She couldn't share the Nobel Prize with them as she died 4 years earlier because of ovarian cancer. This is Watson and Crick, their double helix structure model. And this is a structure of a DNA, the double helix structure of a DNA. So we can see that it is made up of two polynucleotide strands, which is running anti-parallel to each other. Means one is from 3 prime to 5 prime, the other one is 5 prime to 3 prime. Each strand coiled in right-handed helix, and it is like a twisted ladder. In some houses there will be twisted ladders, so it looks like that ladder where the sugar and phosphate forms the backbone for the strands, and the steps of that ladder is the nitrogenous bases where purine and pyrimidine forms the bond between them, which attaches the two nucleotides. The base on one strand is complementary with the base on the other strand. If one strand, if it consists of a purine adenine, the other strand which should contain thymine. If one strand contains guanine as a nitrogenous base, other should contain cytosine and vice versa. So here you can see that base pairing is always between the purine and the pyrimidine bases. That's the reason why the DNA diameter is always constant. Chargaff's tells the base equivalence rule. That's always the number of amount of purine is equal to amount of pyrimidine. That is A plus G is always equal to T plus C. So if A is 40, for example, if I take an example, A is 40 means T will also be 40. If G is 60 means C will also be 60. So that's the reason why the amount of purine is always equal to amount of pyrimidine. So A plus G is equal to T plus C, or A plus G by T plus C will be always equal to 1. That's constant. The double-strand DNA molecule has a diameter of 20 angstrom, and one full turn is called as one full gyre, which consists of 34 angstrom distance. And this form of DNA consists of 10 base pairs. Okay, they contain one full turn, consists of 10 base pairs. That's why this is called as a B form DNA, AB, so B form of DNA. Watson and Crick proposed the B form of DNA. If you see the distance between the two successive pairs, it will be 3.4 angstrom. Whenever the nucleotides, one nucleotide attached with the other nucleotide, there will be a small twist which occurs. An angle between the successive pairs will be 36 degree twist. So if you take 10, so it will be 360 degree. So that's why the DNA always rotates. It's like a turning. Okay, it will not be straight like a ladder, but it's a twisted ladder. So when they form this twist, there are two types of groove which will be formed. One is a major groove to 22 mm wide, and a minor groove 1.2 mm wide. So nitrogenous base of one strand always links with the nitrogenous base of other strand by a very weak hydrogen bond. Types of DNA. There are two types of DNA based upon their free ends. If it is free, then it is called as linear. And this linear form we can see in the eukaryotic chromosome, pox virus, cauliflower mosaic virus, T4 bacteriophage, etc. Whereas if you see in a bacterial chromosome, they are joined. There is no free end, that is joined, it's circular in nature. So if the two ends are joined, then it is called as a circular DNA. So bacterial chromosome, plasmid, organelle DNA, mitochondrial or chloroplast DNA, they are all circular DNA. Forms of DNA. DNA is divided into 5 different forms based on the base pairs in each gyre. It is A, B, C, D and Z form. A, B, C and D are right-handed helix. They rotate in a right-handed way, whereas Z form in a different angle. That is, it has a left-handed helix. A form has 10 base pairs, B 10, C9, D8 and Z has 12 base pairs in each gyre. Watson and Crick proposed the B form, which had 10 base pairs in one gyre. Functions of DNA. DNA acts as a genetic material and it transmits the character from parent to offspring. It is genetic material in almost all the organisms except few viruses, where RNA plays a role of genetic material. It controls the metabolic activity of the cell. It regulates the protein synthesis by the process of transcription and translation. Mutation occurs in DNA are responsible for the evolution.